Penguin Random House Audio presents Renegade Women in Film and TV by Elizabeth Weitzman. Read for you by Mojan Marno. Introduction. Here's the good news. There have been so many game-changing women in film and television that it would take volumes to cover them all. In fact, women have been involved in every aspect of movie making since the 19th century, when director Alice Guy Blachet helped invent the art form itself. Guy Blachet was French, but there are so many incredible women throughout the history of global cinema that this book is focused on those, like her, who've worked primarily in the U.S. As it happens, the early years of cinema were among the most open to women. Silent film director Lois Weber was as celebrated in her day as Ava DuVernay and Patty Jenkins are in ours. Screenwriters Frances Marion and June Mathis were the top earners in all of Hollywood. And one of the highest-paid actors around was the revered Alla Nazimova, a bisexual feminist immigrant. Who knew? Well, that's the bad news. The answer, of course, is that too few people have even heard of these incredible pioneers. As movies hardened into a big-money industry, women found themselves increasingly pushed aside. Their courageous struggles against systemic inequality and prejudice often went unnoticed, or worse, were flatly discounted. Eventually, their names faded from memory, as did their exceptional accomplishments. Moreover, this dismal trend traveled across an entire century, bringing us all the way to today. But culture shifts in fits and starts, and Hollywood has been experiencing a seismic evolution over the last few years. Once again, women are claiming their space. The Time's Up and hashtag MeToo movements have brought horror stories out of the shadows, but have also revealed tremendously impactful examples of bravery and strength. At the same time, box office smashes like Wonder Woman, Black Panther, and Crazy Rich Asians have served as incontrovertible evidence that audiences are done waiting for diversity and representation in entertainment. So are the actors, writers, and directors who have long been impatient for more. And here's something interesting. You know what happens when you follow the trail of female filmmakers? You wind up in television. It turns out that women in entertainment do the same thing women everywhere have always done: create new opportunities out of imposed limitations. In 1953, Ida Lupino was the only high-profile woman directing in Hollywood. By 1956, she'd turned to TV and barely looked back. In the decades since Lupino and movie starlet Lucille Ball forged this path, it's gotten a whole lot wider. Alison Anders, Cheryl Dunier, Mary Herron, Nicole Holofcener, Kimberly Pierce, Karin Kusama, Catherine Hardwicke. These are just a few of the filmmakers who have expanded their careers into the broader landscape of television, and also people whose excellent work you should check out ASAP if you haven't already. Consider this. Out of 1,100 top-grossing films released between 2007 and 2017, women made 43 of them. 43. Four of these filmmakers were African-American, two were Asian, and one was Latina. But more women working means, well, more women working. More women supporting one another so that more women's stories are told. And nowhere has this been more evident than on TV. From The Mary Tyler Moore Show and Murphy Brown to Girlfriends and Gilmore Girls, the best shows have always been the ones to make room for talented women both on screen and behind the scenes. Voices rise higher together. We've seen that in the past few years more than ever. The immovable object that is Hollywood faces the unstoppable force of filmmakers like DuVernay and Jenkins, or showrunners like Mara Brock Akil and Shonda Rhimes, and others follow. A few people are brave enough to speak out about sexual harassment, and others follow. An award winner uses an acceptance speech to demand equality, and others follow. Soon you have whole movements, which means, dare we say it, genuine change. Many of the trailblazers you're about to meet didn't have the benefit of movements. They kicked open doors while carrying heavy burdens and paid an oppressive price. The stories in the first half of this book are often bittersweet at best. You'll wish the renegades who worked so hard for the rest of us could have seen the changes they wrought.
Sample complete. Ready to continue?